We are going to start the next session. Slightly delayed, still. I'm actually very proud of my program. We have Schmidberger working for actually owner, managing director, shareholder, managing director of all the things as Vital and beautiful as part of it. Armida. And we also close with a company called Dost, which does and they decided a while back, you maybe explain a few details, that in order to take full advantage of the nice features of these industrial printer printers, they need software that drives these printers in a very nice way. So a big project was started a while back. And we're very proud that we are providing the technology for putting the system together that have developed. We have a couple of other technologies, I guess we mentioned that. But I think it's one of the most exciting developments of such systems I've seen in the last years. And that's not only because it's our technology design. It's just one out of many reasons for that. So Hans-Peter Schneeberger and Peter Kleinheimer is also working for some of the time. Join you from the
thank you. Welcome again. My name is Hans-Peter Schneeberger and they are producing action on the table, UV and low vibration inks, with UV and low vibration inks, yeah? And also for textiles with reactive and pigment inks, for ceramics, for glass, and for industrial painting solution of wood, liquid on wood, on floor, and on ceramics, on whatever. These are some typical prints here. This is the production of ingredients, and that's our R&D department, and that's the production area in prison. We started 2 years ago, exactly 24 months ago, to start from scratch to develop a workflow system for our labor, and we started with the business in labor packaging. The TUST workflow label is a complete print operating system for organizing, preparing, optimizing, and rendering print items up from the digital press. The main benefits are it's a browser-based front end. It's easy to use, we hope so. The automation capabilities are enormous because we have, you will see that. And we can also deal with colors, as we, Peter will tell you something about how we deal with colors in our environment. And the integration of standard applications, such as Adobe Action Labels, for example, Illustrator, we have to develop a plugin for Illustrator so that we have. We can check out and check in some files from our working system and make it a smooth workflow. So the main goal is just to use one application to do everything. For some reason, you have to change to switch to dedicated application for a certain. We have now about 4 flavors, just the basic flavors, just the rendering to the tile is the printer from those, the Lego printer, the rolling mode. Is up to 48 meters per minute. Print speed, we have a small flavor. That's just for handling one print item, and medium and larger handling more of them, and especially doing more composition and so on. And also we do additional colors, and that's the reason why we choose color washing to handle also the device and colors. Okay, just switch to our workflow. So that's our workflow. Just let me start here to set up the color, how we can do the color management, how we handle color management. Yeah? We have here something like called to do the color measurement, to do the measurement and to calculate profiles is rather standard. We use something like, as you can see here, for example, we would have a overview of all the color setup. We do the visualization. Yeah? We print the chart and use the first one where we have implemented, for example, the VHG. For example, if you want to have, in this case, it's just a one page, so we don't have any. We want to have an imprint, for example, we want to put a white over the white area there, do the rotation and so on. And that's done in the background using the chip, do all the imposition and all the editing of the name of the print and when it's printed and so on. So we do just the print the situation then. We have integrated something, some measurement device, the X-Fly, the Barry technology, and also the measurement device, the Coma, and so on. And we do the measurement, then we do something like the analyzing. So we have the curves where we can edit the curves. And then we just create something like the visualization curves to set the maximum minimum search angle and so on. Yeah? And we do rather standard, we do the visualization and the profiling. Switching to the profiling, we have, for example, here we have 6 pages, yeah. So we have the need to Then we have the local calculation, so we implemented something different. Our goal was to measure one, and that we have digital prints and issues. The goal is to reduce ink consumption. That's the goal. Yeah? And to reach that, we have implemented something like that. We measure once and create out of one measurement set different ICT profiles. For example, when you have a CMYK origin one printer, yeah, so for some reasons it could be helpful just to print with CMYK or just with orange or with violet and so on. And for some reasons we generally set up some templates, we call that color setup templates for the best match situation, for the economy situation, and maybe for the standard situation. Yeah? So that the customer can choose the setting. So we create the measure once and create out of that different kinds of profiles, different kinds of separation settings for profiles, and also a six color based profile and also a four color or five color based profile. So doing that, we calculate more of these profiles, and just have a look to the maybe to the profiling template so that you can imagine how we do that. When we create something like the Weissling profile, for example, yeah. So we have, as you know, the typical bar meters for generating a profile, and what's very important, we as we are using N-Gen technology. And use this and do not work with the white CMYK bar on the top. We have all these parameters. The customer can decide any parameters. Yeah. Then he also wants very important to keep some colors clean. Yeah, to keep primaries clean. For example, they always have other because on the end surface they always have some cyan marks and they will become that and they're not happy about that. And so it's very important to set up a color management setting that they can handle pure colors for the people who doesn't match setting, but it's important to do that as well. And also, as you can see here with some random methods, it's part of the color matching technology we have implemented here. So the customer gets 3, 4, 5 different settings depending on the segment we will provide, and they can choose and set up the color setup and choosing here now in the profile section, they can choose all these based on the settings, and they can choose all the settings and generate other four measurements and different profiles. You will see that later, but this will affect to the calculation. And so yeah. And the goal is, as you can see here, for example, the goal is to have something like the boost color cloud. We put some cloud then. We have for all the boost customer some measurement data available for any substance, because we have a lot of substances, digital as you know. And to handle all these substances, we want to have the possibility to support our customer with measurement data so that they can do a profiling just in one step using just a reprofiling technology. Yeah. So downloading all this measurement set, calculating the standards of all these profiles, and then do just a reprofiling where they can create something like just it's not calculated at the moment. Do the calculation for that, for example, then you can see how far they go away.
Transparency and color management might have faced the issue that
color management on the live PDF, on a PDF with live transparency has some certain issues. Because one very easy example I give very often, you can define a black element. And in addition to this black element, you can define, for example, a 50% alpha channel. It means on the output, there's a 50% black, but on the PDF level, the black is still 100%. If you now have a color management where the leaks, as an easy example, change the tint value of black up by 10%, for example. So the request is make 60% out of the 50%. If you now have the PDF with this black element, which is set to 50% alpha, means you would need to change the transparency parameters and not the color itself. Then furthermore, we are not just in a CYK only world of digital printing. We deal with digital printers that work with additional colors, as you have heard, green and violet and blue. And the transparency model of PDF is, if I put it in an easy way, it only works either in the CYK mode or in the RGB mode. With spot colors, the possibilities what you can use with transparency is very limited. And whoever, I don't know who of you already have dealt with a feature in the PDF toolbox that's called device end conversion. So take a CYK element, run it through a device link, and make a X color element out of it. The results when this element has some transparencies applied are sometimes very, very real. So we decided the color management we do is not in the PDF, but we render the PDF to either RGB or CYK cluster set plus individual separations, and all the color transformations we do are then actually done on the rendered element, which means what I see in Acrobat or the rendering of for example, yeah, what you see in Acrobat, the transparency effect that you have in Acrobat can be carried over to the rendered file, and all the color management that is needed, convert the individual spot colors to multicolor separation is then done on the rendered file, and that is where I see we went really a different way. We got every time you deal with color servers, for example. All these color servers have an option where the PDF gets flattened. Let's put it that way, because whoever deals with color servers knows if you want to have a predictable output, you have to flatten the files. And I have to say, the whole industry was waiting for a print engine to come at some point. So when the print engines came, we had the possibility to render PDF with live transparency, and as soon as the companies came out with the color servers, very often they flattened all the transparency back in the flat file, meaning even if you have access to a print engine and you run it, you have a color server up front, you end up with a PDF that could have been handled by an older regular. We wanted to preserve the PDF with the as long as possible, and therefore we decided to do all the color management and based on the rendered result.
Okay, just a short explanation. Okay. To deal with in digital, we also have to deal with a lot of substrate, so it's very important to have a good overview and technology to handle all the substrate. So, mostly we do the import of the substrate from the printer. Yeah? Then we configure all these substrates, defining where do the calibration on that, do the programming on that, and then we define some substrate definition, because initially you have the same web, for example, and you have the different sizes and different thickness and so on. So we have the need to handle this. The next thing is also to deal with different printers, yeah? In one workflow, for example. As you know, we have maybe six, seven colors example, we can define some general configuration so that we can handle the profiling with different general configurations and do a profiling of a setup upfront or based on that certain printer configuration. So that's very important to have different kinds of ink technologies, different kinds of color combinations and so on. So, but finally everything is done. We have created all these print items. We have created all this printer, we set up the printer. We import all the substrates and configure all the substrates. Then finally, we are just working on that in our workflow. So we have two main steps. The first is the order step, and the other one is the action step, for example. Dealing with the order, for example, is just you have a lot of these, you can search for everything. Yeah? You can dive into one order, for example, public data, you see the order items and so on. You have a list of all these order items. Going into that, you will see a detailed view about all these different types, for example. Yeah? So we're just creating a new job for how we do that. Maybe that's the latest. Then we have a need for to deal with some customers because our workflow is able to handle some specific colors for customers and also some nestings or whatever you need, yeah. And also the invoice address because you have the need to print on the printed substrate the invoice address or the delivery address or whatever. Then you enter some other items, then you have a contact person, for example, then the delivery address or whatever, yeah, a due date and so on. And then that's a typical way how sales guys in print companies are working. In small companies, they have just one printer, for example, they don't really know what they are doing sometimes. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So in some cases they have just substrate categories, and for this category they see, okay, it's just the one substrate profile here, and so they see, oh, we can print it on that printer and that printer, for example.
Maybe we have to define which person is using that step at the moment. We are, for example, you are a sales guy, you get a PDF, and the request is now, you don't want to go to the printers department for them to look at the PDF and tell you what can be done, but the goal is, you define here, for can you put that back? Very often when the sales guy only knows he can the print job in hand on a transparent material or an adhesive material or whatever, and what color combination, what printer is can be used is a completely different thing. The goal is that this salesperson only needs to find the material he wants to print from. And so we know in the background, based on all the colors that we have seen before, which printers are available, and we can then calculate which printer we would better use to utilize the full gamut, for example, of the print item, or which printer shall we utilize to get the lowest cost.
Yeah, then the sales guy gets the email with the PDF or whatever, then he just drops in, for example, this print item, and the customer tells him, okay, it should be 145 by 177, for example, something like that. And it should be just one copy. They need 2,000 of labels they should print, and if the sales guy is familiar with color management, you can see which color policy should be used. Yeah? Or is it legal file or not? So that's all he has to define. You can put it automatically based on an XML file or JDF file, and so on. That is the manual note created. And what are creating the order, we will upload the file, and as you can see, we do the pre-flight, the background, and we calculate all the previews for the content. And finally, we it's done. You see it here. That's our job we have created, and you see some red bars because the customer tells you that, told you that it's 154 by 170. Exactly, it's 145 by 170. So, to either he has informed you in the wrong way, or the printer doesn't fit, and so on. So we have this is just one printer, no, it's two, and so on. There's some layers inside, we have all the information about boxes, bit job information. We have the minimum and the maximum resolution, so that we have this idea what is inside this here, and...
Yeah, but also to tell a little bit about what was going on in the background. The PDF was obviously up a little bit. We used the colors, the Showbooks SDK to prepare the file in certain ways. So we do apply some fixes where we think they do not harm the PDF to make the PDF more stable. And we also use obviously PDF Showbooks to get all the information what you see here.
Yeah,
for example, we don't just check, for example, is the image resolution to no special digital printing. To be honest, at the point where the PDF comes in, you cannot really say the resolution is too low, because you have different ways to output it. You want to print it on LFP with a much with a scaling factor. You might do something. Some other stuff, and that is why we have chosen to give it what is the minimum and the maximum resolution of the images in the PDF. Same with the font size.
The fonts inside.
There's no fonts inside.
But you see the CMYK is used, the small color is used, and also the technical color line is inside the PDF. And here we have all the separations. And for that reason, we have or just take inside and have something like a lightbox. Yeah? So you can either select the dialer, so you can see the dialer is not set to overprint, for example. We have a measurement environment here to check out all these colors, because we sometimes we need some color values here, and so on. Yeah? So that you can zoom in and so on. Just to check out and measure all these the information out of the PDF file. Yeah? And now the print operator has the need to do, the files are managed now, but now he has the need to do the data preparation. Do the data we'll do that afterwards. So for the first step, for example, the request size is one, but there are two pages inside. Okay, we have implemented the split feature, you know that, but just split this, so we will split this page, this PDF, in two print items in the background. Yeah, we have to wait a little bit after 30 seconds when the check is done, and because we have to apply the check and generate the print items in the background and re-import them and do all the pre-filing again and do all the rendering files in the background, for example. Yeah? So just see there are two print items now, see there are two pages now, they are okay, and the size is, for example, we have applied the fix on that two-page print. So we have now two PDF pages, two separate print items. So for that reason, I also fixed that, for example, that's okay, some of the 45 or 170, that's okay. If you want the deep, you have the deep to scale a little bit all these PDFs, yeah? We have here for scale page content to a specific size, for example. And as you know, all the things are short edge and the long edge, and we know all the scale options. We can stretch it a little bit with from inside, bit from outside. We know all this property from the toolbox and so on. We have just implemented that in a way. Every customer can use that. And not really deal with this horrible.
So we decided, you see, we have different sections. We have different sections here in that, let's call it digital job sheet, and depending on which section you are, you have different fix-ups. Like here are all the fix-ups that deal with the size of the PDF. We need to go down to spot colors, there are spot colors, but we have in here the
subset D with problems. We try to find a decent set of fix-up per category. Nevertheless, the customer who has the need for some special fix-ups that do not fit in that view can load in the KFB trials, or you have to consult them in the KFB trials as variables, and we can load them in as well and apply them to the whole view here.
So, and then the six guy has to calculate a little bit, yeah? And to do the calculation is very important to minimize, to optimize the ink consumption. For that reason, I've told you we have different kinds of profiles, both the economy standard, estimate, and so on, yeah? And who wants to find the cheapest way to produce this print item, for example? I will just calculate it all. So, what we're doing in the background, we do the home rendering, the final rendering to the which it will be applied to the Turing random output. So now you have all this information here, and so you see if you use the standard with the CYKOV setting in the HD mode on this printer, you will be 1,000. It will be €4, and okay, that's fine. I will check that. I will use that. Now that's set for as a base for that one. Yeah. So, but if you have a look to the print item for that, you see it here, we have a pseudo peer. Yeah? So you will see that it's not important to have this thing here, yeah? We can cut it off, or for example, we have a rounded corner here, you will see it's not, we don't have the need to have this. So for that print item, we have a new feature, and the new feature is done by colors for us, yeah? We click the print item with the digital feed using the shape technology. And we have the information about all the colors inside, we just do the AI and set up the bleed digitally. We have a laser cutter, maybe 1 minute we can find and apply this. And now we are going to apply this fix up to that print item. So it would be better, you see it here, you can select all for the printers. Normally, the customer has always the same printers with different colors or different. So we can select all and apply this check for all these print items, for example. Yeah. So now you can see it here. Yeah, we have here marked it up. Yeah, everything is fine. And so to again, I will just be here and do a recalculation based on that, for example. And then you can see before it was €4, €1,000. Afterwards, you will have €3.7 per 1,000 for that main bank, for example. Yeah? Okay? So, and as Peter
mentioned. What's the background? The PDF goes really through the rendering. We apply to the color management using all the different devices programs we have generated. The spot color mapping, and then we even do some dithering to really calculate how many dots are then really created, and based on the information we have from the print vendor, how much ink will be consumed based on the amount and then the size of dots, we can calculate back the approximate cost per print item.
So and then we have some fix-ups for forms, because if we have the need to open the file in Illustrator, for example, to apply a function, then you have to convert the forms to outline, for example. Or here we have a fix-up that's a process color. We can map the process color to the data. For example, the customer has a set of data to just change that, we need a spot color, a color for that. You can do that. Or here, what a weight. It's something like that. So there's a customer who sent these items, but he has forgot to add the dynamic. Just do this, select all of it, apply dynamic, not to trim blocks, to the irregular shape, for example. Yeah, set to magenta, whatever. Dynamic and with a certain offset. So I was waiting for 9.1. To deal with the offset, now we have to apply the double size of just maybe 2 points, yeah? the offset, for example, if you add an island and apply it to all of the spring islands, then all the springs are fixed in there, one after the other, so we have added that every time. It's very important here. It's done in the background step as well. As you have a browser, you can switch to another browser, to another window, and use it work on another file. This is not the background. So, for example, what's also very important, for some reasons we have the need to switch while this is working in the background, just check it. So the context one is again still calculating. So obviously I will show you that. So you see that there's a print item, you see the island here, which is added to the context sheet here. While we are checking in, we also have to do the random and all the calculation, also have the possibility to calculate exactly what the value can achieve on the substrate, for example. Yeah? And if you want to reduce that, yeah, just go to the spot color definition, for example, and then there we have the to set up. That's very important for the customers. Yeah, we are just recalculating all these spot colors based on this set profile. So we generate on the fly the real spot color profiles. And for this reason, you see it here. For example, that color, for example, can be set that's based on the real driver. You have these alternate colors here. And we found in our system a pattern library with these LED values, but you want to optimize that, and so you can check that for a certain customer. When the customer always sends you a pattern red 0, 3, 2, for example, you can apply a spot color and optimize that spot color, for example, or you can change to a device, see how many oranges used, and to optimize the orange values for that and so on. So now this color is set.
Also something important, that is also a reason why the feature should be a spot color, and the spot color on a 7-color printer, for example, shall always be printed with this additional color. In PDF, as you know, we can have a spot color, and then an alternate color space. There is no way to define an alternate color space using 7-color printer. That is also the reason why we have shown where we agreed it to be able to have for each spot color different pre-calculated or pre-defined 4-color definitions or X-color color definitions defined depending on the printer that is available to, for the data.
So we have defined this color now. We see it on the simple here that it's a customer-based setting here, and that's a library-based, and that's a print-based setting. Have added some small icons to identify exactly what happens in Germany. And just to have a look to the spot color, as you can see, we now have a customer specific spot color. It's defined for people's digital, for example, to exactly that value is for. And for the other thing, we have defined something like an eye line or whatever. Yeah, an eye line could be just set up system-wide. Eye line can be set up system-wide, and for example, just magenta, 100% magenta, can be set as a technical color, and also to the cutting, to apply the technical layer, the cutting layer, it's defined, and switching back to this print item, that's that one. So now you can see on that print item that now we have the nylon in the technical section, because we have to find the system wide, the nylon is technical color. So and so we have different fix-ups here, you see all the separations here and so on. Finally, for example, we are ready, and for example doing that, that's about time, then we create something like a production job. The production shop. I will just create one for that one. Then we, maybe two of them. we create a production job, then I switch to the production job, for example. And now we have here the production job. And finally, the production has to be planned. Yeah.
And we also have information about the difference between the order and the production job. The order is always customer related. And on the production job, we can put various print items from various customers together on one sheet. So that's the difference between order is customer related, whereas the production job is more production related. It's related to the customers and not afterwards.
So just tell me a little bit of your typical job on the label industry for three of the same labels with different colors, for example. And we just break up where the housing has just to check the printers and which print on which substrate again and on which color points here what's used. Then you just switch to the editor in our context here, and in those editor, for example, we have to import some defaults, yeah, or can define the default. That's a frequent item spaced with a link from 1.2 millimeters, for example. If you want to add a little bit more space or less space, you can do that here to see it on the what has been done, yeah. Just to optimize, maybe if we wrote it, that will be or we can set up the marks, enable the marks, or check out the marks and so on. Finally, you're done, yeah. So now you can have the same situation here, and now you just send it to the printer, and press send to the printer. We will now do all the color management, we do the rendering, and do all the dry of the color management.
We have not the individual PDFs. What you see here is what we do in the background is we use PDF chip to do the imposition, to the creation of the marks, creation of the additional text elements that need to go on the screen. And so the result, the background is then the post sheet, obviously, and this is post sheet, goes to the rendering, then we end up with our individual separation for the process tolerance and for the spot tolerance, and then we apply them to the color manager.
That's our process. This is the running which process are doing. Yeah? In the meantime, I will just quick view to our Illustrator plugin. Because in Illustrator, sometimes, for example, we have data was very important for us to do that. For example, this is a label. We check that out. We have designed a plugin to do that. Check the file out. Open the file or just
to pinch such a bit. I thought you had some VPN and it's slightly faster.
No. So for example, now we have here the access to the label here, and as you can see here, we have already defined here some QR codes using our handle with it. And we set up all this property. What's very important for us is if you, for example, you have just to create a barcode, for example, just choose the barcode here. I mean, which kind of barcode? We support all the barcodes inside the. Good idea. Code number 28, for example. Okay. Then just add, for example, the text here, text for barcode.
Obviously, we can also connect the barcodes to the CSV file to generate the dynamic barcodes.
So, as you can see, that for example, show the text here, we generate the background, okay, it's a little bit huge, maybe
5. Again, what's done in the background? The barcodes you see here are generated on the server in the background because Illustrator by itself obviously doesn't have the support for so many different barcodes. So everything, all the available data that you see are generated by a PDF chip as a PDF reader and sent back to the Illustrator plugin. And we actually use Illustrator just as a viewing tool of PDF for whatever reason in the packaging industry. Illustrator is obviously a very common tool to open PDFs and look at them. Sometimes also edit them. We all know it's not the best idea, but that's the way it is.
And what's very important, just from one sense, is the additional parameters which are all important. That's very important. In addition, you add value of production. Yeah? For some reason, we have to add up to 40% value of production to get a fine barcode on the digital printer, for example. And as you can see in the here, it's always rendered live. So then we will, okay, I have rendered it now 1% of that. And then, okay, the value of production, and what is the challenge was to add barcode in the Illustrator and send that back to our workflow system and keep all these coordinates available for our system so that we can finally also deal with inside this